As climate change and growing urban populations place increasing pressure on our cities, innovative ways to make our towns more livable are in demand. In 2008, Visions showcased Australia's first research green roof, which was developed by researchers at the Melbourne School of Land and Environment. Their study identified plants that could survive in extreme conditions and found that even a small green roof could reduce summer energy cooling demand by 38%. The team have now literally built on these results to develop the Burnley Green Roofs project, which was officially launched last month by the Vice-Chancellor and the Melbourne Lord Mayor, Robert Doyle.
So green roofs have a range of environmental and economic benefits that can help make our cities more livable. They can reduce the energy use in buildings by acting as an insulating layer and stopping heat gain by the buildings and therefore reducing air conditioning costs. They can also act as a sponge, absorbing rainfall and stopping the massive amounts of runoffs we have off our hard surfaces in urban areas. And this will improve the ecology of our streams and rivers. So despite the benefits of green roofs, they're not very common in Australia compared to overseas countries like North America and Europe. And this is because the Australian climate is very different and the models that they use over there don't necessarily work in Australia. So we've been developing substrates and plants to work under Australian conditions. So as well as this demonstration roof, we also have a research roof and a biodiversity roof where we'll be using to do research to understand how green roofs can function better. We've got a range of indigenous plants that act as larval food sources for butterflies, and also including structures such as tiles and flower pots where lizards and insects can live.
Such a significant roof structure required inventive solutions from the planning team, which was led by the multidisciplinary design practice, Hassel.
When we began on the project, we had to examine all the limitations working with the existing building. So, for example, the building is heritage listed. One of the other big limitations with any green roof is the structural capacity and loading. What could we actually put on top of it safely? To get a really high quality outcome with the fabrication of the space, assembling things off-site allows us to get a much higher quality result. It's not something that's usually undertaken in landscape work so much, so it's quite unique and it's kind of like a jigsaw puzzle going together on site. It's very much flexible use space, so it's about bringing people in to showcase green roof technology, but it's also about day-to-day teaching and learning. We have essentially four main teaching spaces, and that's why the edge continually builds up around there, so we've got constant seating opportunities around the perimeter.
The intention was to create something that was quite beautiful here, but at the same time illustrated a lot of different functional green roof types. What we have here is 14 different planting zones, from shallow 100 millimetre depth through to 300 mils or 30 centimetres. Some areas of the roof are irrigated and some are not. The irrigated sections are working on very low irrigation, but we're using harvested water off the site. And most of the plants here, probably 95% of them, we've grown directly in our nursery. In this particular demonstration green roof, there's more than 200 plants here. And there would be more than 3,000 to 4,000. We actually don't know exactly, but we certainly know that that number of plants was what ended up on the roof here. So the ultimate aim of the diversity of all these zones and different plantings on the roof is to show what's possible. So there's many, many research questions that can feed our teaching and better engage us with sort of industry professionals that we want to bring up here and use this space.